Welcome to Video Blade Magazine. I'm Specialist Sandra Mercado.
And I'm Army PFC John McMasters.
On this edition of Video Blade, we'll take a look back at the year 2001.
And we'll take a look at soldiers getting down and dirty at Camp Pendleton, as well as a message from General Ostenberg. The Army has a new addition to their uniform. Sergeant Baldwin Yen has the story.
In October, the 63rd Army Reserve Command celebrated the addition of a new piece of clothing to the uniform. The black beret, a longtime symbol of excellence, replaces the camouflage cap in most situations. Officials say the beret represents the Army's commitment to being a lighter, more mobile force. The reserve units of the 326th, based in Bell, California, marked the change of uniform with a beret donning ceremony. Soldiers who wore berets in the past helped less experienced soldiers before the ceremony. Although some practice was required in donning the berets, in the end, these soldiers were standing tall and stepping smartly. Reporting for Video Blade Magazine, I'm Army Sergeant Baldwin Yen.
Operation Enduring Freedom makes mobilization a top priority for the 63rd RC. Specialist Mercado, do you have something on that?
Yes, I do. Army reservists are looking at more than just 1 week in a month, 2 weeks in the summer, after the events of September 11th. They have to be ready at all times in case their nation calls on them. Units Army-wide prepare for that call by conducting a mobilization exercise, or MOBEX. Commander of the 222nd Broadcast Public Affairs Detachment, Captain Greg Gordon, emphasizes the importance of the mobilization exercise.
Mobilization exercise is where a unit goes through each individual soldier's records, whether it's personnel files, equipment files, and make sure that everything is squared away so in the event that the unit is mobilized, these soldiers are ready to deploy.
The 222nd BPAD, located in the city of Bell, conducted a mobilization exercise last September, coincidentally 4 days after the terrorist attacks on 9/11/2001. The event showed the true importance of being prepared to mobilize at any given time. Soldiers prepared for mobilization by updating all necessary records and emergency contact information. 222nd Detachment Sergeant, Sergeant First Class Maurice Simmons, explains the necessity for the MOBEX.
The last thing we need a soldier to do when he is deployed is worry about his family back home. And a mobilization exercise will ease those fears when he's deployed.
Reservists have been doing their part in today's Army by serving tours in such countries as Kosovo, Bosnia, and Saudi Arabia. By conducting the mobilization exercise, units can be assured that their soldiers are ready to go. Now ask yourself this, will you be ready when you are called to duty?
We'll be back in a moment.
To be an American citizen is a great thing, but to be an American soldier, that's my greatest source of pride.
There's something special about the soldier of the Army.
Something special.
Something deep beneath the uniform you see.
Something special.
Soldiers with civilians working hard to keep us strong. Paying the price for America's liberty.
Active Army, National Guard and Reserve. Three different opportunities to learn and to serve. You can earn an education, serve your country filled with pride. Gain confidence, learn the special skills Army training. Strong and free.
Mommy, would you please belt me?
Daddy, I deserve to be belted. Mommy, I really need to be belted.
There's only one reason to belt your kids, and it's a very good reason.
Thanks.
Soldiers facing possible deployment can rest a little easier. Sergeant Michael Sanop tells us why.
The 63rd RSC cares about its soldiers and their families, so it created the Family Readiness Office. There, they train volunteers to assist families once soldiers are deployed.
And the whole purpose of the Family Readiness Group is to provide assistance to the family members of the soldiers when they are deployed. So that's our main function.
Lieutenant Colonel Bookwalter's Transportation Company learned the value of the program firsthand.
They were instrumental in working with the soldiers and eventually with the families when they came in. And what their role was to do is to gather all the information on the families so that they can support the families once the unit has deployed from the site.
Ella Bookwalter is one of the family readiness volunteers for her husband's unit.
And also to them become more familiar with us so that they would know when they left that their family members would be fine, that we would take care of them and be there for them in any shape or form.
For Video Blade Magazine, I'm Army Sergeant Michael Sanop.
We'll be back in a moment.
I don't have a clue. So help me God. I guess you can say it's a soldier thing. It's the bond that keeps us together.
Following through until the job's done right.
Really appreciate you staying late. I know that took up some of your time. It's not about rank. It's about the golden rule.
Placing the welfare of my soldiers above my own.
It's a matter of living up to all Army values.
Inspector General's office, hold, please. It's about doing what's right, legally and morally.
Having the inner strength to overcome all my fears.
Attend all drills and annual training as scheduled. Make sure to make up all excused absences.
Be MOSQ, or if you're an officer, branch qualified.
Pass the APFT. Participate in a unit PT at all times in the right uniform.
Always wear the Army uniform properly and proudly.
Meet the Army's height and weight standard. The goal is to do it without being taped.
If you say you're going to do something, do it.
Watch out for yourself and your buddies. Safety first. Don't drink and drive.
Treat others with respect and caring. There is no room in this command for sexual harassment, racism, and disrespect for others.
Be trained to standard, proficient with your personal combat training tasks, qualified with your personal weapon, and able to take care of yourself in combat.
Know and demonstrate through your personal actions your Army values.
Welcome back.
The United States Army Soldier Show performs on Army posts worldwide. Sergeant Ray James reports on the Soldier Show from Fort Irwin, California.
The United States Army has a job to defend this country and its way of life. The United States Army Soldier Show has a job to entertain those soldiers and their dependents. A small group of soldiers from around the U.S. are chosen to perform at Army bases around the world. The United States Entertainment Committee selects about 20 to 25 active duty and reservist soldiers to participate in a traveling Broadway musical. Reserve Officer Lieutenant Wendy Brown, an MP from Washington, D.C., tells how you can become a part of the Soldier Show.
Well, what you have to do is send a copy of your talent on a VHS by December 31st of last year. And what they did was view all the tapes and then select the top 25 finalists. We then came to Fort Belvoir and did a live audition. Actually, we had a week-long of audition. Then we did our final live audition on that Sunday, and they selected the top 21 people.
This talented group of soldiers danced and performed songs like the 1980s group, En Vogue, the 1990s groups, Backstreet Boys and NSYNC, country and western superstar Clint Black, Latin's guitarist Santana, and R&B singing sensation Barry White. With more than 200 soldiers and dependents in the audience for the first of two shows, the show attracted a special group of guests from the Veterans Home in Barstow, California. Physical fitness is a part of soldiers' everyday life. The Soldier Show is no different. Specialist LaVon Thomas tells how much of a physical challenge it is.
It takes a lot, again, which is why a lot of us like to work out in the morning. You have to keep up yourself physically. You have to keep a real good, strict diet. And it's very strenuous. It's, I would say, even more strenuous than being in a regular unit.
Reporting for the Video Blade magazine, I'm Army Sergeant Ray James.
The Entertainment Committee selects the soldiers 4 months prior to the performing year. If you'd like to work in the Soldier Show or perform, you can contact the Army Entertainment Committee at Fort Belvoir, Virginia.
Your physical fitness plan doesn't have to be so routine. Camp Pendleton Marines host an unusual event two times a year.
It was a beautiful day for a run around and through Camp Pendleton's scenic Lake O'Neill.
Come on, guys, get in that mud! No mercy, come on!
It didn't take much to motivate the 3,500 military and civilian fitness buffs who sacrificed their bodies and their tennis shoes to the Marine Camp's 7th annual mud run. Runners tackled 10 kilometers of slick, muck-filled pits, climbing walls, streams, torturous tunnels, and steep hills, all in the name of fun. Organizer Jim Duckworth described why the event has become so popular.
I think the success of the Camp Pendleton Mud Run would be the fact that people just like to get dirty and have fun and be an eight-year-old again.
Marine Corps Corporal Gary Hirsch was one of many who conquered the course.
We got Marine Corps, we got Army, I'm sure we have Navy, Air Force, I'm sure all branches, a lot of civilians.
For civilians, the course was billed as boot camp for a day. For Private Paul Days, it was a test of his endurance before he left for basic training.
But this is just kind of a, just to see if I'm ready. Oh, I'm ready.
So does the mud run motivate you?
Yes, it does. Yeah, it's like, I didn't run with a team. There's a lot of people that ran with teams. I ran solo, but it's like, you see the guy in front of you, they'll stop and start walking. You tap him on the shoulder and yell at him, like, don't quit, and they'll start running again. You know, they just, it's awesome.
Running or wallowing in the mud isn't a jog in the park. For many, it was exhausting. And while victory over the grueling course was sweet, the mud wasn't.
It tastes bad! Oh my God!
But nothing was more satisfying for the dozens of teams who pulled each other through the gauntlet than the finish line. For Video Blade Magazine, I'm Army Sergeant Laura Corbin.
Do you think you have what it takes to conquer the mud run?
You know I do.
If you do, visit www.camppendleton.com for more information.
For your information, alcohol was involved in nearly 41% of all car accidents over the last 2 years. In about one-third of all traffic fatalities, at least one driver or pedestrian had a blood alcohol concentration of 0.10 or greater. So please, if you're going to drink, don't drive. And if you do drink, drink responsibly.
The 489th Maintenance Company won the 2001 Western Region Philip A. Comley Awards. They competed against 200 units in this region. Major Robert J. Redford talks about the prestige of the award.
Let me tell you about the recognition. I think that the morale is improved because the soldiers will see on their wall and in an encasement the coveted bowl that we present to them today.
The 489th competed in the field category. The cooks worked hard at preparation and displaying the meal. When the hard work ended, the soldiers enjoyed some hot, tasty food. Sergeant First Class Eddie Carradine talks about the pride his soldiers take in their jobs.
What made it so outstanding is most of us have civilian and military education in food service. And we take pride in what we do.
A civilian evaluator judged them on their performance. Individual members of the 489th received certificates and the whole group received a plaque. Major Robert J. Redford from the U.S. Army Reserve Command then presented the soldiers with the Western Region Trophy. Reporting for Video Blade Magazine, I'm Army Sergeant Brian Malanafy.
Clear the runways, the 63rd RSC has a new commander. Brigadier General Robert B. Ostenberg assumed command from Major General John L. Scott October 21st at an airfield on Los Alamitos, California. When asked about the 63rd's readiness, both new and former commanders were confident about their troops' training.
We had an alert the other day of our 314th MP Company, and within 6 hours we had 85% of our soldiers there.
We're at the highest state of readiness right now than this organization has ever been at, and General Scott got us there.
Now, with the current situation in Afghanistan, they feel we will face new challenges in getting the reserve troops deployed quickly.
The challenge now is we can do our jobs. The question is, can we get out the door in as little as 72 hours? Because that's what our last deployment time was.
Reporting for the 302nd Mobile Public Affairs Detachment in Los Alamitos, California, I'm Army Sergeant Karen Olson.
Welcome back.
And now, some important messages from the command staff.
I want to talk briefly about the RSC vision. The vision is an integrated team of soldiers and civilians and families focused on unit and individual excellence. We're proud, we're confident, we're capable, we're called first because we're the best.
As you know, the CG has a vision, and every organization really needs to have a vision so they know where they're going. The units are a team of ready individuals who are capable of performing the unit mission.
You can look at any organization from the largest team members, if you will, the presidents, the CEOs, or work all the way down to the to to the action teams, the ones that get things done. And I think if you would identify yourselves at whatever level you're at, you can identify the fact that the team has to work together to be effective. What changed in September on the 11th and weeks after that is we're finding that we didn't have 4, 5, 6, 7 months to prepare.
Then September the 11th come along, a devastating blow to America, but the 63rd RSC, as the rest of the One Army, we stood up and we met the challenge.
Thank you for joining us on this edition of Video Blade Magazine.
This has been the 2001 Year in Review. I'm Army Private John McMasters.
And I'm Specialist Sandra Mercado. See you next time.
So, yeah, I never...
Yeah.